This is really fascinating. It turns out that smell and memory are controlled from the same area of the brain. So researchers said, gee, I wonder if maybe smell problems show up first. So they took healthy volunteers and they tested their sense of smell. And the folks who had trouble distinguishing different smells, well, they were much more likely to get Alzheimer's later in life. So the smell, or lack thereof, the ability to smell really did a great job at predicting who was going to get Alzheimer's.
Interesting indicator. How about the eye test? What can the eye testing show us?
Well, it's interesting. With Alzheimer's in the brain, you get these plaques and these tangles. You can actually see them when you do an autopsy on someone. And when they looked in the eye, they saw some of those same plaques and tangles. So again, able to predict, not 100%, but with a great deal of accuracy, who was going to get Alzheimer's based on what their eyes looked like.
So here's the big question. We know that these tests exist. What is the possibility of them being incorporated into testing when we go into a doctor's office? How soon will it be?
You know, I think it's going to be years, but I do think that it is very possible that one of these tests will be available from your doctor. There's also a blood test for Alzheimer's that they're doing research on. The big question is going to be, do you want it?
Right.
You know, I think the technology's there and it's going to happen, but do you want to know when you're, let's say, 45, that you have a very high risk of getting Alzheimer's when you're, say, 70?
That's a good question. Another moral dilemma for us to think about. Maybe in
it
my 70s
is.
I might want to know, not in my 40s. I already know I'm
Maybe
forgetful.
Not.
Elizabeth Cohen, really interesting developments there for us. Thanks so much for joining us.